Pastor John Fleming of the Open Door Churches, the United Methodists of Salem, Keizer. I'm here to welcome you to worship this day. As we begin the season of Lent, may God's Spirit guide us. May God's Spirit enable us and empower us. May God's Spirit hold us accountable to the witness of Jesus Christ. And may we all keep these things in mind as we pray together. God of the wilderness, be with us as we wander through the desert of our lives. Keep us from running back to the safety of old assumptions, and walk with us as we learn to live the life abundant. Amen.
Our scripture lesson today is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 4, verses 1 through 11.
Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. He fasted 40 nights and 40 days, and afterwards he was famished. The tempter came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread."
But he answered, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God."
Then the devil took him to the holy city and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and on their hands they will bear you up so that you will not dash your foot against a stone.
Jesus said to him, again it is written, do not put the Lord your God to the test.
Again the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. And he said to him, all these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me.
Jesus said to him, away with you, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him.
Then the devil left him, and suddenly angels came and waited on him. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Hi, friends. I'm Pastor Kalina with our message. It is the first Sunday of Lent in our sermon series for the Lent season is Uncovering the Divine. And today's message is Uncovering the Divine in the Desert. Let's begin with this prayer. Almighty power, authority, creator of our universe, and most loving God to us, let this Lent season remind us to humble ourselves before you and repent our sins, to free our hearts and minds, and ready to be filled only with Jesus' love and grace. Open our hearts and mind to hear, understand, clothe, and arm ourselves with your word, so that we'll be able to counter Satan's temptation when it comes our way. May your Holy Spirit alight with us in this virtual space, in this worship time. Amen. I was in a worship planning retreat last summer when we read this passage of Matthew to plan for the Lent season of 2023. And we were asked to look for a word that came into mind. And the words that came out of our discussions were uncovered, exposed, and revelation of the divine in Satan. In this scenario and setting, they were in the desert. We have learned from our reading of the Old Testament that the Israelites had journeyed through the desert. It seems like that the desert setting is a place or ground of uncovering, discovering, and revelation of, and learning and testing about the divine, about God, the devil, and the community of the Israelites. But God has these Ten Commandments that he gave the Israelites to help them and guide them to stay faithful to God. And we learn that the devil would succeed in many times in luring the Israelites to disobey these rules. Here in our New Testament passage that we had read in Matthew, it is the story of the temptation of Jesus Christ. And the setting was the desert. Here in this story, it demonstrates the stumbling blocks we face living out these three important things in our lives. They are authority, the power position, and our pride, the possessions of how much we have, and also our basic human rights for basic necessities and provisions to survive, like food. To live into our faith as disciples of Jesus Christ, fundamentally, we are called to obey and observe God's commandments in and through our conversation, actions, and practices. We are expected to know this commandment by instinct from the dedicated practices of reading the Bible, prayers, and active practices of fasting and extending of living out grace and love in a community. This may sound maybe a little easy or hard, but we know that this is very hard to live out. The fundamental truth of practicing Christian living like Jesus is very hard to live out, and it is a daily struggle for the faithful disciples. The temptation of Jesus' story uncovers for us the truth of the divine authority and right and power. It seems that every action God brings, it invites an opposite reaction from Satan. From our reading of Matthew 17 last week, Transfiguration Sunday, as soon as Jesus and his disciples went down from the mountain, they were met by the devil. A son who was possessed by the demons, too strong for his disciples, could not cure, and then was waiting for Jesus, and Jesus was able to cure him. The previous chapter 3, Jesus' baptism, it ended with these glorious words of uncovered from God's from God's realm. It says, "This is my son, the beloved, with whom I am well pleased." I prefer the New Living Translation because it's more endearing. It says, "This is my dearly loved son, who brings me great joy." What beautiful words to come from the son's father. Then this next chapter, the chapter that we read today, following those lovely words, Jesus was led by the Spirit to the desert. This uncovered here that it was God's will for Jesus to be tempted by the devil. We wonder about sometimes how bad things happen to good people, but we know that they do. It happened to Jesus too. The Spirit led Jesus into the desert, but the important thing we learn here is how Jesus prepared for his encounter with the devil. He fasted. The max days of fasting of 40 days, 40 nights. Elijah did this too. Jesus prepared a ready space for the devil to tempt him. He was very hungry from the long fasting, and the devil knew this is a perfect timing for his first move. The devil approached Jesus to say, "Why do you stay hungry when you know that you can turn anything to stone? Anything, even this stone, into bread to eat." Jesus didn't hesitate to answer and quoted from Deuteronomy, "It takes more than bread to stay alive. It takes a steady stream of words from God's mouth to live." So the devil knew that he cannot come counter that. The second test, it's a test of pride and position. The devil took Jesus to the top of the temple and said, "Since you are God's son, jump." The devil used Psalm 91 for this. "He has placed you in the care of angels. They will catch you so you won't so much as stub your toe on a stone. Jump. The angels will catch you." And Jesus again countered with a citation from Deuteronomy, "Don't you dare test the Lord of your God." And the third test, they were at the huge mountain. The devil pointed out all the earthly kingdoms and how glorious they were. And he said, "They are yours, lock and stock and barrel. Just go down on your knees and worship me. They are yours." Jesus must have had it with Satan, but this time he refused him and said, "Go away, Satan." And with another quote from Deuteronomy, he said, "Worship the Lord your God and only him. Serve him with absolute single-heartedness." The angels, when the tests were over, because the devil was gone, the angels of God came to tend to Jesus. If there is any message I want to bring to you this first Sunday of Lent, is to pay attention and notice how Jesus prepared for this exam, that great temptation from the hell devil. It is uncovered to us by the divine Son, Jesus. To prepare, we fasting from food, but feeding from the words in prayer and in prayer. Again, I repeat, Jesus demonstrates to us a practice to follow, fasting from food, but feeding from the words in prayer. I bet you, if we read the book of Deuteronomy and know it by heart, we will always be ready to stand against the devil. Our temptations comes daily. My Tongan brown pride is a stumbling block for me. I sometimes humble my brown self by saying, "Your big island Tonga, the sacred self, is only 99 square miles, very small. It can fit into one of the biggest lakes here in the States. It is tiny. You have no rich natural resources either. Thank God you have coconut in the island, a fruit of grace to drink and eat." We all know that we are tested with our white pride, black pride. And when we are tested with that, and whatever pride that we have and we hold, we often panic, and fear cause us to take the easiest way out offered by the devil. Our message today, Jesus teaches, no matter how bleak the situation is, know, trust, and obey your God in every situation. Disciples, Peter, learned from this temptation of Jesus' story. The preparation to counter the devil is to be fluent in knowledge and practices of God's commandments. 1 Peter chapter 8, verse 5, urge us to discipline yourself, keep alert. Like a roaring lion, our adversary, the devil, prowls around looking for someone to devour. Resist him steadfastly in our faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same things, same sufferings. But after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be the glory forever and ever. Let us pray. Almighty Savior, thank you for Jesus' teachings, not only with words, but with the journey he took. We pray for your Holy Spirit to journey with us in our holy journey in this season of Lent. Amen.
Teach me the way. As we enter into this time of prayer together with one another, I'd like to remind you that if you are joining us for the live premiere of this worship service, the worship video has a chat function. We encourage you to place your joys and concerns and prayer requests in the chat. You're also welcome to place any of your joys, concerns, and prayer requests in the comment section of this video. And we want you to know that we are praying with you and we are praying for you. Please join me in a spirit of prayer. Loving and gracious God, to you we lift the prayers spoken in our spaces, prayers in our chats and in our comments, prayers that rest in the depths of our hearts, prayers of thanksgiving, prayers of hope, and prayers of healing. For we know, O Lord, that we can bring all things to you in prayer. Today, on this first Sunday of Lent, we hear what for many of us is the familiar story of your son being tempted in the wilderness. We witness the ways in which Jesus continues to point to your word, no matter what temptation he is faced with. As we continue to learn what it means to be a witness for you, O Lord, help us to learn from the example of Jesus, to continue to be and to learn how to be witnesses who point to your word and to your guidance, that we may lean on your word for courage and support and hope during times of trial and temptation, that we may share your word of love for all with the world. As we enter this season of Lent, O Lord, lead us and guide us that we may grow ever deeper in our relationship with you and in the ways in which we live out our life of faith. Together on this first Sunday of Lent, we join together as your children. We say the prayer that your son taught us to pray, sharing, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen." You now.
God is holding your life, we believe. God is holding your life, God is holding your life, God is holding your life, we believe. Venturing out or staying home, neath heat of day or cool of night, we call on one who hears your voice and comes to heal and keep your life. God is holding your life, God is holding your life, God is holding your life, we believe. God is holding your life, God is holding your life, God is holding your life, we believe. God is holding our life, God is holding our lives, God is holding our lives, we believe. God is holding our lives, God is holding our lives, God is holding our lives, we believe.
Offering is a spiritual practice, one in which we continue to learn and grow throughout our life of faith. Our offerings can be shared through our gifts, our time, our talents, our spiritual gifts, and our financial resources. If you would like to learn more about offering, I invite you to go online to our website at opendoorchurches.org, click on the Giving tab, and that will provide you information you need to know. As we give thanks and praise for the ways in which we have been blessed in our own lives and are bringing those offerings to God, we pray our offertory prayer. Here, Lord, we put our love into practice. These gifts we offer came from your love for us. Now, let them express our love for you as they reach out to others with your love for them. Amen.
Hi, friends. It's Pastor John. I'm here to bring you this week's Open Door Church's Minute, and this one is a true pleasure. On behalf of the Open Door Church's board and the pastoral team, I'm pleased to share with you this wonderful news about our sibling in ministry, Pastora Zaida Huerca. Zaida, for the last 3 years, has been leading the Las Naciones Hispanic Fellowship. And she was a lay person assigned when she first took on that ministry, filling in for the previous pastor who was unable to return from a trip to Cuba. And so here we are, 3 years later. She has been working exceptionally hard, and now she has achieved one of the milestones in her goal as she continues to seek further qualification for ministry in the United Methodist Church. Pastora Zaida has been enrolled in licensing and course of study classes over the last 3 years, and just recently she finished that course of study and was qualified as a licensed local pastor in the United Methodist Church, and has been appointed by Bishop Cedric Bridgeforth and Superintendent Tim Overton Harris as a licensed local pastor. This is an incredible achievement, and I hope that you will continue to celebrate that. And if you have the chance to send a greeting to Pastora Zaida with some congratulations and some best wishes. She is really a gifted pastor. When you see her in action with her congregation, it is a true blessing and a joy. So, friends. We continue to develop a team of ministry, and as we continue to seek more members for our team, as PastorAlyssa leaves our team for another assignment, I hope that you will pray for us in every way.
Thank you for worshiping with the Open Door Churches community. And let us part with these blessings. May the God who made heaven and earth, whom death could not contain, who lives to disturb and heal us, bless you with the power to go forth and proclaim the gospel. The grace of God be with you all, now and always. Amen.
God, you are my God, and I will never praise you. Oh God, you are my God, and I will never praise you. And I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways, and step by step you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my days, and I will follow you all of my days, and I will follow you all of my days, and step by step you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my days. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. And I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways, and step by step you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my days, and I will follow you all of my days, and I will follow you all of my days, and step by step you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my days. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. Oh God, you are